Hello students, this is Sweetal teacher. Today we will understand Unit 4, Topic Subtraction in Mathematics for Standard 4. I have added textbook pages for reference. In the previous lesson, we have learned about the rules of subtraction. We revised subtraction of 3-digit numbers. We also understood subtraction of 4-digit numbers without borrowing. Students, today in this lesson we will understand subtraction of 4-digit and 5-digit numbers by borrowing. Let's start by subtraction of 4-digit numbers by borrowing. When subtracting 4-digit numbers, we can use the same method as we did when subtracting 3-digit numbers. Let us solve one example. 5634 minus 3251. First, we have to arrange the numbers in columns as per their place value. Thousands, hundreds, tens and units. Remember, when subtracting, first number always goes on top. Here, the first number is 5634. Minus the second number, 3251. Let's begin with the unit's place. It's always top number minus bottom. Unit's place is 4 minus 1, that equals to 3. We write 3 under the unit's place column. Now we move on to tens place. 3 minus 5, always remember, top number minus bottom number. 3 minus 5 is not possible because 3 is smaller than 5. So we have to go and borrow from hundreds place. Here we go to hundreds place, that is 6 will become 5 and it will give 10 to tens place. 10 plus 3 is equal to 13. Then we have 13 minus 5. 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. We write 8 under the tens column. Now we move on to the hundreds column. Remember, it's always top minus bottom. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. So we write 3 as answer under the hundreds column. Next we move on to thousands place. So 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. We write 2 as answer under the thousands column. Now we get the final answer as 2383. We can use this method for a higher number of digits. Remember to use place value headings. Arrange in columns and always write the first number of the subtraction calculation on top. We will solve the first sum. 4215 minus 2649. First, arrange in columns and write the place value headings. We will start from the unit's place. 5 minus 9. 5 minus 9 is not possible because 5 is smaller than 9. So we have to go to tens place and borrow. Tens place, 1 will become 0 and unit's place, it will come 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. Now we can move further. 15 minus 9. 15 minus 9 is 6. We write 6 as answer under the units place. Now we go to tens place. Here 0 minus 4. But 0 is smaller than 4. So we have to borrow from hundreds place. Here 2 will reduce to 1. And tens place, 0 will become 10. Now we can move 10 minus 4. 10 minus 4, answer is 6. We write that answer under the tens place. Now we go on to hundreds place. 1 minus 6. 1 is smaller than 6. So we have to go to thousands place and borrow from 1000. So 4 will become 3 and here 1 will become 11. Now we continue. 11 minus 6. 11 minus 6 is equal to 5. We write 5 under the hundreds place. Now we go to thousands column. 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. Here we get our final answer, 1566. In this way, we can solve the other sums. Students, these sums are there in your textbook. If you have your textbook, you can solve them, or else you can practice in any other book. Now we will learn subtraction of 5-digit numbers. When subtracting 5-digit numbers, we use the same method as we did for subtracting 4-digit numbers. Let's solve an example. 86,574 minus 74,254. First, we have to arrange the numbers in columns as per their place values, starting from units, tens, hundreds, thousands, and ten thousands. Then we arrange the sums. 86,574, put the minus sign and write next number, that is 74,254. We begin with the units column first. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. Remember the idea? Numbers the same, zeros the game. So we write 0. Next we move on to tens place. 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. Go to hundreds place. 5 minus 2. Answer 3. Next thousands place. 6 minus 4. Answer is 2. Now ten thousands place. 8 minus 7. Answer is 1. Here we now get our final answer, that is 12,320. Remember students, we always begin by subtracting the units column followed by the other columns. And always check your answers. Now we will solve some more examples with 5-digit numbers without borrowing. You have to remember to arrange them vertically. These sums are there in your textbook page number 26. You can practice these sums. Now we will see an example of 5-digit numbers with borrowing. 96,365 minus 65,626. First, arrange in columns and write the place value headings. Begin with the units place. 5 minus 6. 5 is smaller than 6. So we go to tens place and borrow. 6 will be reduced to 5 and 5 will become 15. Now we have to subtract 15 minus 6. 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. So we will write 9 as answer under the units place. Go to tens column. 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. Write 3 under the tens place. We move on to hundreds place. 3 minus 6. 3 is smaller than 6. So we go to thousands place and borrow 1. 13 minus 6 is equal to 7. So we write 7 under the hundreds place. 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. We write 0 under the thousands place. 9 minus 6 is equal to 3. We write 3 under the ten thousands place. We get our final answer, 30,739. Now students, in the same way, we will solve these sums which are given on textbook page number 27. You do this as home practice. Also, do this home activity given on textbook page number 28. The question is, add and subtract the following pairs of numbers orally using your own method. Students, I hope you enjoyed today's class and understood the concept of subtraction. Keep learning and keep studying. Thank you.